Have you ever thought how big are Tesla semi chargers? They are called mega chargers and they are huge. And one of them, a big truck charger for Tesla semi, is now spotted in Las Vegas. It has interesting stuff that I'm about to show you. Welcome back, friends. This is Armin Haryan from torquenews.com. If you are here first time, please subscribe to this channel for daily Tesla and electric vehicle news. And if you would like to support us, I would greatly appreciate sending us super thanks because they help us a lot as ad revenues have really fallen if you have benefited from this charger. So Tesla semi truck charger is spotted around Las Vegas. As you can see, the Tesla semi chargers are very large and kind of overweight. Notice that it has a compact layout. It looks like Tesla truly can just drop it off and have an electrician lend some cables and throw a switch to turn it on. Very quick. The guys on X, former Twitter, say it's located on Southeastern Avenue in Las Vegas. If you guys are in that area, I would appreciate if you would like to send me some pictures or send me some videos, make a video of that if you are in Las Vegas, Southeastern Avenue area. You can see my email in the about page of this channel. Tesla announced in November 2022 that it would be deploying new 1+ megawatt hour mega charger for its Tesla semi electric truck. These chargers will be capable of adding up to 400 miles of range to the semi truck in just 30 minutes, making it possible for the truck to travel long distances without having to stop for long periods of time to charge. Now, from what I understand, of course, Tesla Cybertrucks will also be able to use these mega chargers to charge their trucks, but this has to be confirmed. The first mega chargers for Tesla semis are expected to be deployed in 2023, and we already see them, and will initially be located along major trucking routes in the United States. Tesla has also said that it plans to make the mega chargers available to other electric vehicles in the future, such as, like I said, Tesla Cybertruck. Now, couple of days ago, I reported that Tesla wants to have $100 million funding to build Tesla semi-charging stops. I think 9 or 12 of them between Texas and Northern California. That's one major route. And I also see that Tesla is now working to connect Giga Nevada to California, another major trucking route. Here are some additional details I would like you to know about mega chargers for Tesla semi. They will use a new V4 charging connector that is capable of transferring up to 1+ megawatt of power. They will be able to charge the Tesla semi's 100 kilowatt hour battery pack from 10% to 80% in just 30 minutes. This is enough time for a truck driver to have a little break, to get something to eat if they will build infrastructure in that area. Tesla semi mega chargers will initially be deployed in the United States, of course, but Tesla has said that it plans to make them available in other countries in the future as soon as Tesla starts selling and exporting Tesla Semi, or we see other gigafactories in the future building Tesla Semi, or at least building the assembly lines for Tesla Semi. And they will also be able to be available for other electric trucks. Tesla Semi mega chargers are a major step, friends, toward for the electric trucking industry. They will make it possible for semi trucks to travel long distances without having to stop for long periods of time to charge, which will help to reduce emissions and improve air quality. The mega chargers will also make it more feasible for businesses to adopt electric trucks, which will help to accelerate the transition to a clean energy future. Are you excited about this? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. I would appreciate your support. For super thanks, guys. God bless you, and I'll see you soon in our next report.
In a new video, Pepsi details how its Tesla semi fleet is helping its reach sustainable goals. Welcome back, friends. This is Armin Haryan from torquenews.com. If you are here first time, please subscribe to this channel for daily Tesla news. The Tesla semi truck is perhaps the most groundbreaking vehicle in the commercial industry in decades. In Sacramento, California, Pepsi is using 21 Tesla semi trucks to help reach its sustainability goals. And now Pepsi has some more details and numbers for us. In a multi-year effort that aims to reduce the company's carbon footprint, Pepsi is depending on the semi battery forklifts, Ford e-transit vans, and other battery electric vehicles to help operate the full logistics logistical load at its Northern California plant. Here's what Pepsi says. Battery electric vehicles are essential for us, Amanda Devoy, Pepsi's transformation and strategy director, said. It's really ground in our duty cycle. It asks how we use our assets because of good majority of our business is anchored in going to market. We deliver predominantly under 100 miles on a daily basis, and we run those vehicles around 12 hours a day. Pepsi runs Tesla semi vehicles around, like I said, 12 hours a day. Like, looks like they're very busy with Tesla semi. The semi is among the most crucial to the company's business practices, and the company and its employees have quickly adapted to the ever-changing landscape in commercial logistics. Devoy said the use of electric vehicles is most advantageous for this type of short-range travel from Pepsi's distribution warehouse in Sacramento to where it will deliver vehicles. Three of the 21 Tesla semi trucks that Pepsi uses at the Sacramento facility are dedicated to the long-haul routes, which range from 250 to 450 miles. The Tesla Semi technology, especially with regenerative braking, has been a monumental help for Pepsi, especially with the routes that include Donner's Pass. Deja Antunovich, Pepsi electrification program manager, said the following. Going across Donner's Pass and back from Sacramento to Nevada, we're able to, on the trip back, actually zero out in terms of state of charge improving due to regenerative braking. It extends range for us in a way that is invaluable. Transport drivers and fleet managers at Pepsi stated the mega charger has helped tremendously with the travel, helping Tesla semis reach 95% state of charge within 20 to 30 minutes of charging. They also commented on how comfortable the Tesla semi's interior is and how easy it is to drive due to the throne's positioning toward the front of the vehicle. Many of the truckers have said that it will be difficult to drive or back to the with the seat being in the middle. But apparently Pepsi drivers are very happy with this. Maybe there is a way of doing that. It took 3 years for Pepsi to prepare for the sustainability project to really take shape at the company, which required 3 megawatts of additional service to the facility. Actually, it says 3 MW. I honestly don't know. I assume it's megawatt or something like that. However, the project is years ahead of schedule due to the mass adoption of electric vehicles at the Pepsi plant led by Tesla Semi. So as you can see, Tesla has some good numbers for Pepsi. Actually, Pepsi seems to be very happy with that, and their video is very interesting. I can't help but recall all the YouTube videos by truck drivers to how this vehicle will be a disaster. So far, that does not seem to be the case, as the testimony of several of the Pepsi Tesla Semi truckers show the opposite and attests to the strong usefulness that Tesla Semi brings to them. Let me know your thoughts, friends. What do you think about Tesla Semi and its future in the trucking industry? This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. God bless you, everyone. Please subscribe to this channel and see you soon in our next report.